astonishment in the mighty Man Company Manor, Saxton Hale presents Alamo Suspense Stories, the only comic that guarantees a murder at the Alamo in every issue. In this Alamo-packed ish, murder! At the Alamo? You won't believe the terrifying answer.
Yippee-di-yay, abominable Alaminions! After my terrifying trip to the South Pole and our last anxiety-inducing-ish, I felt a vacation to a warmer climate was just what the doctor horrored. Luckily, two old fools rented me for a meeting in New Mexico. Read on, Fort Fiends, because they're about to get a bit more than they bargained for in the rental agreement. Or should I say, rental bereavement? In a story I call
Blood Brothers.
Redmond, we have engaged in a fruitless war for 100 years. We have no heirs, and now we are out of time. Thanks to our pointless bickering, the Mann family line will die with us. It kills me to even say it, but I think you know what I intend to propose. I despise it with every atom of my being, but yes, it's the only solution that makes sense. We must be- Brother, please, dismiss the help first. Leave us. Now! Redmond, I propose a truce so that we can build a machine to make one of us pregnant. Of course. My one concern, brother, is it possible this plan is too perfect? Difficult to say. Honestly, I can find no flaw in it, nor I. So, it's a deal? Yes. I must say, Redmond, it was big of you to suggest this meeting. That tear-stained letter you sent me. What? You sent me a tear-stained letter. Gentlemen. My name is Gray Man. I am your brother, and I sent the letters proposing this truce. Which, I might add, it took you literally 30 seconds to turn into an idiotic crime against nature. Congratulations. Redmond, who is this? I just told you who I...
I don't know, brother, but he could be the key to helping us build our pregnancy machine. You there, young man, are you mechanically inclined?
Yes, you could say that. Well, thank heavens for small mercies, at least she finally stopped screaming. As I was saying, Barnabas, if the sites of infestation are indeed multiplying, so is their need for munitions. Munitions we
can... Mr. Mann? Sir?
Well?
Your wife, sir. She... didn't make it.
Betty.
Yes. Well, and the child?
Children, sir. 3 boys.
Good. At least she did something right. Take me to them. Strapping, alert, handsome. They'll do. Wait, where's the third child?
Sir, he came out so small, and there's something you should know about him.
Show him to me!
Hello, Father.
He can talk, sir.
Blah! Smother it! When suddenly...
What is happening?
Curse you, demon bird! I'll smother you both!
You could talk as a newborn?
I learned in the womb, listening to our mother.
I also invented a new form of algebra to pass the time. We were a late birth, you'll recall. Yet, I was born weak, and that was something our father could never accept. Luckily, Providence intervened in the form of the Great Eagle Scourge of 1822. I was raised by that eagle as if I was one of her own. Frail, helpless. I was fed grubs and mice, accepted alongside her other children, kept warm at night, nestled in her feathery breast. And when I was strong enough, brothers, I ate her and all her children and crawled back to civilization. Unlike you two pampered imbeciles, I built my empire. I have studied, I have plotted, I have waited, and for 150 years I have watched you squander my father's fortune. For God's sake, you bought the Alamo and flew it to New Mexico. For a meeting!
Well, technically we rented it.
And in all the time you've spent fighting this asinine war over worthless pits of gravel, you have not once considered our true birthright. The only thing in this hell-blasted landscape actually worth fighting over.
Worthless pits of gravel? Ha! You poor fool! Whoever owns those pits would be a god! What do you think powers the world's steam engines?
Coal.
No,
it really is coal. Or it was. Engines run on gasoline now.
Graveline, eh? Well, semantics. It's all gravel in the end, of course.
Gasoline. And no, it's not. Again, it's truly, truly not.
Feh! And where will the world be when all this fanciful liquid gravel of yours runs out? No, I have it. We simply need to create a machine that turns gravel into coal. And that coal will power our pregnancy machine, so we can-
Don't worry, he's just dead for a moment. He'll be back in a few-
No, I think I've heard enough.
No, please! We have so much gravel left to fight over! We-